Hello viewers, welcome to Health Profile. Today we are here at Global Hospitals. Dr. Balbir Singh is with us, Consultant Liver Transplant Surgeon. Hello Doctor.
Hi.
It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
Doctor, what is liver transplantation?
Liver transplantation done when we remove the diseased liver completely and give another liver to the patient. Usually it happens when medical treatment fails. And a patient with the liver disease cannot be reversed with medical treatment, and we call it end-stage liver disease. And at that time, the transplant is required.
Doctor, are there any types of liver transplantation?
Yes, liver transplant has various types. One is known as living donor liver transplantation, where a patient's relative gives a part of his liver to the patient. And second time, a deceased donor liver transplant. Any patient who is brain dead, either due to intracerebral bleed or roadside accident, if the family accept to donate the organs, then we take that patient organ, liver, and give it to the patient. There can be other types also. A split liver transplant, where can the deceased donor, means a patient who brain dead, whose liver we have taken, we can split into two parts. A small part we can give to a younger child, and the other big chunk we can give to the adult patient. Sometimes transplant is known as auxiliary liver transplant. Especially it is done paracetamol poisoning. When the liver has acutely failed, you give a part of the liver to the liver and place it there, keeping the old liver intact.
So when
the liver regenerates, liver has a capacity to regenerate. So when the old liver becomes healthy, we can stop immunosuppression in this patient. The new liver will die on its own death, or we have to do a surgery and remove that part of the liver.
Doctor, when you do the liver transplant, so you won't remove the liver?
Yeah, we have to remove the liver completely. Except in auxiliary, we don't remove the liver completely.
Doctor, what do you see in a patient to do a liver transplant?
See, we suggest a patient when the medical treatment fails. Medical treatment fails means he gets water accumulated in his tummy off and on, or he blood vomits, or he passes blood in his stool, or he gets legs get swelled up, or he gets encephalopathy, means unconsciousness, elderly when talking, recurrence hospitalization. These are the symptoms where patients should go for liver transplantation.
Doctor, when you decide that, how much percentage of liver damages means to do the liver transplant?
Liver transplant depends on the MALD score worldwide, and the percentage wise, very difficult to say percentage wise. Usually, when more than 80% liver gets damaged, then patient will go for transplantation.
Doctor, what type of test you will prepare before the transplant?
We do a battery of tests on the patient. Most important time, how is the heart and lungs they are going to behave, and the kidney. Plus, we did a lot of blood tests, viral screening of the patient. So a whole lot of batteries tests are done, plus lot of consultants they see him, anesthetist they see him, plus other specialty doctors also they see him, give a fitness. When the patient is declared fit, only then we go for liver transplantation.
When you perform the liver transplant, when you decide that liver is damaged, so what are the main causes of liver damage?
Liver can be damaged due to several factors: alcohol, hepatitis C, hepatitis B, or fatty liver, which is very common nowadays, increasing number in India, is because of the diabetes, obese patients. Sometimes hepatitis A and E, or any drug, antitubercular medicine, or paracetamol, they can acutely fail your liver. Or autoimmune hepatitis, when body tissue starts eating their own tissue. Or there are other factors, primary biliary cirrhosis or primary sclerosing colon. These are the common factors for causing the liver failure or chronic liver disease. In children, most common cause is biliary atresia, where biliary system, bile duct system, doesn't form completely, and child is born with jaundice at the birth.
So what do you do in that case, doctor?
Then we discuss with the patient. This medical treatment is not going to help you. You should undergo liver transplantation. We discuss all the pros and cons. These are positive things, these are negative things. What are the risks, complications? We discuss with the family what will be the outcome, how will be the expenditure, what will be life after transplants, all this, where any social support or not, how is the psychological behavior, whether we stick to the medicines that we are going to prescribe. All these things we look into it. When we think a patient is ready, only then we go for transplantation.
Doctor, what is hepatitis actually?
Hepatitis means liver inflammation. It can be due to hepatitis A, B, C, D, E. These types of hepatitis are there. Most common in India is hepatitis B. Later comes hepatitis C. Hepatitis A and E are usually seasonal variations. Usually they happen during March to July during rainy weather. They are waterborne. Hepatitis A and E.
So they are
due to dirty water, we think, and all those things can cause.
What are the signs and symptoms of it, doctor?
Signs and symptoms of a hepatitis is patient feels they are lethargic.
Okay.
He is not eating well. Yellowness in eye and urine. He may get fever. General sense, no sense of well-being. In children, they may pass a white color stool.
Okay.
These can be the hepatitis symptoms.
Doctor, so when you decide that the patient needs liver transplant, so what do you suggest to the family and to the patient?
We suggest to the family patient that liver transplant is a safe procedure. No, there is no 100% guarantee. But in India, the results are at equal to the world. There are more than 90-95% survival rate. Okay, at 1 year, 5 year survival rate around 75-80%, and 10 year survival is nearly 60-70%. So at par with the equal, and the cost is almost one fourth of the what it costs in the Western countries, and life will be normal life. You can lead a normal life as you were living before transplant. Only thing, you have to take certain medicines for lifelong as of now.
Okay, so doctor, what are the side effects of this liver transplantation?
There are not many side effects. As I already told you, you can lead a perfectly normal life. Only thing, initial period you have to be extra careful because we give immunosuppressive medicines. They lower your body defense, so you can easily catch an infection. We suggest patient not to go to crowded places, or any person who has any cold cough should not come in contact with you. And the medicines you should take regularly. These medicines can cause side effects. Sometimes some people can develop blood pressure. Some people can develop diabetes. And long run, they can affect the kidney as well. So we can keep an eye on the patient investigations, general well-being. We can change the medicine. We can reduce the dose as well. But patient can perfectly lead a normal life.
Doctor, after the liver transplant, the patient can take alcohol?
Usually we don't suggest, because we can have it forming. Once you say you can take alcohol once in a while on a birthday or on a Christmas, any occasion. But if we tell this, our patient will not stick to that. They will continuously take. First they will take occasionally, then with frequency goes and increasing until they will go back to on the normal drinking. So we always say please don't take alcohol. But occasionally, if the learned patient is, occasionally they can.
Doctor, what happens if the body rejects the liver?
Liver rejection is better than kidney rejection. If kidney rejects, then you have to go for retransplantation. Liver rejection, we can always revert with the medicines. Big high dose of steroids, some other medicine, we always revert it back. Usually rejection happens when the immunosuppressant dose is low, or patient is not taking medicine. It's compliance problem. So we take a liver biopsy. And examine the microscope, and there is rejection. We tell to the patient, we admit the patient, we give the medicines, and patient's liver can go, his liver functions can become normal.
Doctor, who can become a donor?
Anybody, any adult. Usually we prefer between 18 to 40 or 45 years of age, who usually should not be diabetic or any other comorbidity, should not be obese. Okay, he can be a donor.
Doctor, what is the life? What is the average life expectancy after the liver transplant?
Liver transplant expectancy life, as I told you, life expectancy is excellent. I have seen patients who are living 25 years, 20 years post liver transplant. Only thing, they have to lead a disciplined life. Can they lead a disciplined life? They can follow the doctor's advice. They can be in touch with the doctors if anything goes wrong. I think there should not be any problem. Usually after 5 years, I have not seen anybody dying because of the liver problem. They are following doctor's advice. Maybe some other cardiac issue, all those things. Age related issue, they can be the problem.
Doctor, what do you see in a donor before do the surgery?
Donor, we usually see general assessment. Blood tests, viral screening, hepatitis screening. He should not be diabetic.
Okay.
No heart issues, no lung issues. And then we do an ultrasound and see how the liver looks. After doing ultrasound, we do a CT scan. In CT scan of the liver, triphasic CT liver, we see how much is the volume of the liver. Volume means how big is the liver in the donor, and how is the anatomy. Anatomy means how are the blood vessels, bile ducts, situated, what is their relation to each other. Depending on that, how old is the recipient, how big is the recipient, depending on which part we have to take for the recipient. The liver volume we calculate and see, no harm should be done to the donor as well as the recipient. But donor is the most important person.
Mm, yes,
so we make sure nothing should go wrong with the donor.
The size should be the same, doctor?
No, not necessary. It depends on the body weight. We usually calculate on the body weight.
Okay.
You can go as low as 0.8 or 0.7% of GRWR, graft versus body weight ratio. If your weight is 70 kg, you can Balbi with the 700 grams or 650 grams of liver as well.
Doctor, will the recipient have less rejection if they are related, the donor?
Not necessary.
Mm-hmm.
Rejection can happen living related as well as deceased donor as well.
Okay.
Related may be almost at equal as well.
Doctor, jaundice can be lead to liver damage?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
All these hepatitis lead to jaundice.
Mm-hmm.
Jaundice can cause liver failure as well.
Doctor, they need to follow any particular diet menu?
Usually they can go for normal diet, whatever they were eating before.
Mm-hmm.
If suppose somebody is diabetic, they have to take care of diabetes.
Okay.
There are certain medicine which needs to be taken empty stomach.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Post liver transplant.
Okay.
So at least 1 hour before, 1 hour after taking that medicine, patient should not eat or drink anything, otherwise drug effect will come down. Another thing is jackfruit, that's in Hindi maybe call it kattel.
Yeah.
They should not eat.
They should not eat.
For lifelong, because some of the medicines,
okay,
they interfere with this.
Interfere with that fruit?
Yes. Otherwise, they can have a normal diet.
They can take meat, doctor?
Yes, they can. But they should try to avoid red meat.
Red meat
is not good for the liver.
They can have
fish, they can have chicken. Should not be a problem.
Doctor, can they do exercise part?
Yes. After certain period, we ask them to wait for 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
3 months means tissue healing takes such time. After that, slowly they can do exercise.
Okay.
It should not be a problem. Whatever they want to do, they can do.
Okay.
They can lead a perfectly normal life.
Doctor, if there any recurrency?
Yes, certain diseases can recur.
Mm.
Hepatitis B, hepatitis C, autoimmune hepatitis.
Mm.
They can recur in the new liver. But recurrence is not immediate.
Okay, not
it
immediate.
Takes at least 10 to 15 years down the line for this liver to become diseased again. That's why we keep an eye. We keep regular checkup of the patient, blood test, liver function test. Sometimes we keep on doing biopsy to keep an eye how the liver is working.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not that immediately it will get affected.
Okay.
No, it will take years together.
Doctor, what they need to follow to maintain the good liver health?
They should eat, do exercise regularly,
mm-hmm,
don't over drink,
okay,
don't avoid red meat if
mm-hmm
possible,
mm-hmm,
okay, and perfectly healthy life, regular exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do anything extra.
Okay. You can suggest them diet menu and exercise and all.
They can eat whatever they want, but not in excess. They should avoid fast food,
mm-hmm,
nowadays.
Hello.
Okay. Sugar, they should cut down sugar. They should cut down red meat, especially mutton and beef. They can have fish. They can have chicken.
Okay.
Not that every day,
mm-hmm,
but at least once or twice
mm-hmm
in a week they can have. They should avoid high cholesterol diet, but they should exercise whatever they are eating, and they should maintain their weight. If they are diabetic,
okay,
they should keep diabetes under control.
Thanks for watching this video and don't forget to like, share, subscribe to our channel. To get latest updates and notification, click on the bell icon. So what is joint replacement? Actually, what do you do exactly, doctor?
Like I said, madam, we replace the affected cartilage with a custom made kind of a prosthesis which is contouring to the near anatomical shape of the human body.
Mm-hmm.
So that along with a polyethylene insert
mm-hmm
makes it pain free.
Mm-hmm.
And also restores mobility.